Electricity is one of the most important blessings that science has given to mankind. It has also become a part of modern life, and one cannot think of a world without it. Electricity has many uses in our day-to-day life. It is used for lighting rooms, working fans, domestic applications like electric stoves, AC, and more. All these provide comfort to people. In factories, large machines have worked with the help of electricity. Essential items like food, clothes, paper, and many other things are product of electricity. Modern means of transportation and communication have been revolutionized by it. Electric trains and battery cars are quick means of travel. Electricity also provides means of radio, television, cinema, etc. Modern equipment like computer, robot have also been developed because of electricity. Electricity plays a great role in the field of medicine and surgery too, such as X-ray, ECG, etc. The use of electricity is increasing day by day.
India is facing a serious power crisis in recent years. Although power development was significant during the last 4 decades of planning, but the generation of power proves insufficient in comparison to its requirement. Thus, the country is facing a persistent power crisis since last few years. Main factors which are responsible for this persistent power crisis in India are increasing demand. Demand for electricity has been increased continuously in India. During 1980 and 1990, this increase in demand was at an annual rate of 9 to 10%. Increase in demand for electricity has been increasing from all fronts: agriculture, industries, domestic. Gap between target and achievement. Another factor responsible for power crisis is the continuous gap between the targets and the achievement of power generation. This shortfall in targets of power generation, which was 15% during first plan, has increased 50% during the fourth plan. Poor planned load factor. The planned load factor reflects the operational efficiency of the power project in condition of excess demand. In India, the planned load factor is very poor. Planned load factor of the project under the ACB of Bihar, Assam, West Bengal, Odisha are ranging from 25 to 40%. Planned load factor of ACBs in general remained all along very low. Other factors which are responsible for persistent power shortage in country includes use of obsolete machinery, huge transmission loss to the extent of 20%, irregular supply of coal, supply or inferior quality of coal to the thermal power plant, labor indiscipline, lack of proper administration, lack of efficient engineers, technicians, skilled labor, unfavored hydro-thermal mix, public sector's monopoly control, etc.
Now I am going to discuss about various methods of electricity generation. There are various methods of electricity generation, as example, from renewable energy, from non-renewable energy. First, we will discuss about non-renewable energy. The main example is coal, natural gas. We use coal and natural gas to generate electricity by combustion. We will discuss in details about this in our next video. In thermal power station, this coal and natural gas are used to boil the water. A steam produced from this boiling water is used to rotate the turbine. This is called thermal power. Now, uranium by nuclear fission or nuclear fusion produced nuclear power energy. To utilize this heat, we use the heat to boil the water and the rotate the steam turbine with the steam from the boiling water. Now we are coming from hydro energy. What is hydro energy? Using the flow of water we rotate the turbine and produced energy. That is called hydro energy. Among the renewable energy, sunlight is directly converted into electricity by photovoltaic cell. Rotational energy by wind is converted into electricity, which is called wind power. Rotating water by wheel running the water to generate hydropower energy. Magmatic heat boil underground water to rotate the steam turbine to generate geothermal energy.